गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन। फाइन ओके चिल्ड्रन, आई एम एसआर यादव, योर इंग्लिश टीचर। टुडे विल स्टार्ट योर न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज द ओपन विंडो। दिस इज द चैप्टर इज टू लॉन्ग, वी विल टेक ओनली पार्ट वन टुडे। लेट अस सी व्हाट हैपेंस इन दिस चैप्टर। फर्स्ट विल गो थ्रू द objectives of reading this chapter. After reading this chapter, you will be able to develop listening, speaking, reading and writing skills among the students. Definitely after reading this chapter, you will be successful to develop these skills. The second objective of this chapter is we'll come to know that the chance usually play a leading role in the drama of life. When somebody gets a chance, he plays an important role in this life. It is always the best policy to speak the truth. And you might have seen there are so many people who can speak English without being caught. They are exceptionally good lawyer. They are liar actually. They are not lawyer actually. Lawyers, they are liars. It is said like this. But there are many who knows very good thing about the facts, and they are extraordinary in their profession. They will never tell lies, but they will stand on the facts. The best policy is to speak the truth. Nobody can defeat anyone once somebody is speaking the truth. Of course, if you are a good liar, if you can't be caught, then there are so many who actually try to speak untrue. All truths are easy to understand. That is also very important to understand in this chapter. All truths, they are very easy to understand once they are discovered. The point is to discover them. Only thing, we are supposed to discover the facts. After it is discovered, it is very easy that that statement was true or false. After that, we'll go through the summary of this chapter. What happens? Let us see, children, what is there in your chapter. Actually, there are two main character. One is Frampton Nuttall and the other one is Mrs. Appleton. And Mrs. Appleton's house, there is a small girl whose name is Vera. Let us see what happens. Once Frampton visits Appleton's family. This Mr. Nuttall, who visits Mrs. Appleton's family once, and why does he visit there? Because he suffers from a bad nerves. Mr. Nuttall calls on Mrs. Appleton, a family friend. He thinks that it is easy to contact Mrs. Appleton for the cure of his nerves. The family friend, this Mrs. Appleton was, who can cure bad nerves. That was the special quality that she could actually cure that disease. The lady was very busy upstairs when he reached to her house. But there was a small girl named as Vera. And this Vera talked to Mr. Nuttall for a long time. Vera is actually self-possessed and calm and confident girl. She narrates a story to Mr. Nuttall. That was cock story. She narrates about the family mishaps. And when she talks with Mr. Nuttall, this small girl narrates a story about their family mishap. And what was that family mishap? She tells him that 3 years ago, her husband, whose husband? Mrs. Appleton's husband, and her brother, younger brothers, two younger brothers, went off for their day's shooting. They went out for their shooting. When they went out, they took a spaniel dog or so. They never came back. That is what the story she was telling. That when one day when they went out, they never came back. All three engulfed. And what happened to them? All three, they were engulfed in a treacherous piece of bog. A piece of bog means a piece of marsh where muddy water is there. They disappeared there. Mrs. Appleton came downstairs and told Mr. Frampton about the tragedy. And the same thing happens when Mrs. Appleton comes down, and when she speaks with Mr. Frampton, she also speaks the same about some the same tragedy. And when it was supplemented, when it was confirmed, at that time Frampton got more nervous actually. He was already suffering from nervousness. But when he spoke about the tragedy with the small girl, and then it was confirmed by Mrs. Appleton, at that time he got actually a bad nerves. He went into more trouble. She created fear in him, and that talk created a fear in him. Mr. Nuttall runs away out of fear, and because he came for the cure and he got nervousness enhanced, he actually increased his nervousness, and that is why he actually runs away from Mrs. Appleton's house later on. Vera and Mrs. Appleton discussed about Mr. Nuttall's fear, who ran out of the house. And later he actually goes out. At that time, this Vera and Mrs. Appleton, they discussed their the reason of running out. And this girl, who was very self-possessed, confident also, very calm also, she was not she was not at all discovered whether she speaks the truth or she is telling the lie. And that is why she was actually extraordinary professional girl, self-possessed, calm and confident. Whatever she used to speak, that used to seem as if she was speaking the truth itself. Let us say what happens in the chapter later on. Before that, we'll just read about the author. The chapter is written by Hector Hogg Munro. He was born on 18 December 1870 and he died on 14th November 1916. He was better known as Saki. Saki was his pen name, and also frequently called as H.H. Munro. He was a British writer who was very witty, mischievous, and sometimes macabre. Stories satirize Edwardian society and culture. Whatever the story he used to write, that used to be satirical. He is considered by English teachers and scholars as a master of short stories. Saki was the son of Charles Augustus Munro, an Inspector General for Indian Imperial Police. That was the introduction of the author. And then we'll go through the chapter line by line. My aunt will be down presently, Mr. Nuttall. Now, this line was spoken by a self-possessed young lady of 15. Whose name was Vera. In the meantime, you must try and put up with me, she said. Since my aunt is upstairs and she is not present at this moment, you should just bear with me, you should talk to me. After listening to this much, Mr. Frampton, he endeavored to try to say something which should duly flatter. Actually, he was trying to speak to the girl, which could please the girl. He tried his level best. The moment, without unduly too much discounting the aunt was that was to come. This is not at all considering whether the aunt was to come or she will come early or late. But privately, he can doubt it more than ever whether these formal visits of succession of total strangers would be of some use or not. Whether they are going to cure his nervousness or they are going to deteriorate my nervousness. So he was in doubt for a moment. Then further what happens? He knows his sister actually once told him that I know how it will be. His sister had once said to him that I know how you are supposed to get your nervousness cured. When he was preparing to migrate a rural retreat, at that time, you will be bury yourself down there and not speak to a living soul. This was the suggestion given by his sister, that if you are going to a rural retreat, at that there what will happen, you will be totally isolated and you will never speak to anyone. And you will just bury yourself, you just die yourself. Feeling of moping there. You will just feel moping. Why? What is that feeling? That you will be continuously feeling unhappy there. And thus your nervousness will not reduce, but it will be increased. I shall just to give you the latest of introduction to all the people I know there. The sister says that I'll do one thing. I'll just give you the letters of introduction to all the people whom I know there. So they are going to help you there. Some of them, as far as I know, I can remember, they are quite better. They are quite nice. So I'll just give you the letter of introduction. You can go there. You'll never feel isolated. And you will mingle with them. You just cure your nervous. And then Frampton wondered whether Mrs. Appleton, the lady whom he was presenting one of the letters of introduction, came into the nice division. Frampton here he wondered. He says whether the letter which was addressed to Mrs. Appleton was of any use. Was there any use of that particular letter? Is he going to be a nice division? Is that lady is going to be in a good category? Whether she is going to help me or not? He was in doubt. He wondered. Then niece continued. She says, do you know anyone here? When she asked like this, when the niece asked like this, if he knew anyone there, he said, no, hardly a soul. He said, no, I don't know many people here, because the niece observed for a long time and there was a sufficient communion, there was silent communion, there was silent relationship between them. And after that, she asked a question that whether he knew someone there or not. Then he said, hardly a soul. But he said continuously that my sister, who had stayed here for somewhere 4 years ago, she has given me a letter of introduction to some of the people here, and I'll just get contact with them. I will stay with them. I will just get help from them. That is what he was discussing with that 15 years of old young girl, who was niece of Mrs. Appleton. Let us see what happens further. He made the last statement in a tone of distinct regret. Actually, when CE was making the last statement, he regretted that the arrival of his to that remote retreat was there, was it of any use or not. Then you know practically nothing about my aunt. When this was the reply, niece told that, I think then, according to the situation, you don't know anything about my aunt. Pursued the self-possessed young lady. This self-possessed young lady continued her talk. And then only her name and address admitted the caller. He said, yes, definitely. I know only her name and address. And not much about Mrs. Appleton, your aunt. He was wondering whether Mrs. Appleton was in a married or widowed state. He tried to find out whether Mrs. Appleton was married or unmarried or in a widowed state. An undefinable something about the room seemed to suggest masculine habitation. But that undefinable something, that something which was not definable, suggesting that there was a habitation of masculine. Some of men, they used to stay there. Sorry. Her great tragedy happened just 3 years ago, said the child. The 15 years young niece said that in this house, a great tragedy happened somewhere 3 years ago. That would actually be since your sister's time. I think that was the time when your sister used to stay here. And then what happens, after listening to this much, Mr. Frampton said, her tragedy? Asked Frampton. Somehow in this restful country, spot tragedy seemed out of place. I think that is unusual to listen, that in such type of restful or a peaceful area, retreat, there may be a tragedy also. So it is very astonishing. It is just strange. You may wonder why we keep that window wide open on an October afternoon, said niece, indicating the large French window that opened onto the lawn. There was a window which was opening towards the lawn. The niece asked, do you know why do we keep this window open? In this hours, in these months, that means this is the month of October, in this October afternoon, why do we keep this window open? Do you know this mystery? Yes. It is quite warm for the time of the year, said Frampton. There was a reply from Frampton that they may be quite warm for the time of the year, and that is why you must be keeping it open. But has that window got anything to do with the tragedy? But you are telling something about tragedy. Has that this a window got anything to do with this tragedy? Out through the window 3 years ago, to a day, her husband and her two brothers went off their day's shooting. They went off for their day's shooting through this window only. That is only the connection. What is the connection of the window? The connection of the window is that through this window only 3 years ago, her husband, means Mrs. Sapleton's husband, and her two brothers went off. And where they went? They went for their day's shooting. They never came back. She added that after going, they didn't return actually. In crossing the moors means that marsh, that place that where muddy water is there, through that they were just crossing up to that favorite shooting ground. But by the time All three, and gulp were swallowed in the treacherous, dangerous piece of bog moss. In this moss where they were passing through, they went into that, they were engulfed into that particular dangerous, treacherous piece of bog. It had been that dreadful, and this bog had been so dreadful, and wet in summer, you know, that the place that were safe in other years gave way suddenly without warning. Without the warning, during summer, it was very nice place, but without warning, that season, it did not give any chance, and that engulfed all three. Their bodies were never recovered, and the tragedy was such that the bodies were never found. Now, that was the dreadful part of life. Actually, that is what the great tragedy, she says. And after that, we can see the picture. Mr. Nuttall is listening to the story from this young girl of 15 years whose name is Vera. She's very talkative. She can make stories, and she is befooling this old man. He is just very serious. He was already suffering from nervousness, and that the nervousness has increased a lot now because of her talk. The child's voice lost its self-possessed note and became falteringly human. Because he was self-possessed girl, when she was speaking, her tone changed. And the tone was changed into a falteringly human tone. She said, "Oh, poor aunt always thinks that they will come back someday. And that is what the hope my poor aunt has, that they will return back, they will come back. They and the little brown spaniel, the dog they took, that was lost with them. And walking at that window just as they used to do. She still hopes that they will just come back through this window as they used to do, as they used to do. That is why the window is kept open every evening till it is quite dusk. When it gets dark, and up to that time, she always keeps this window open." Poor dear aunt, she has often told me how they went out, her husband with his white waterproof coat over his arms. Actually, my aunt used to tell me that how her husband had gone out with white waterproof coat on his arms. And Ronnie also, her brother, used to tease her youngest brother, singing, "Bertie, why do you bound?" That is what she used to say. This Ronnie used to call to Mrs. Chapleton. And that was the remembrance she used to tell the young lady. As he always did the tease her, as he used to do this to tease her, because she said it got on her nerves, because she used to say that it actually gets on her nerves. Do you know, sometimes on still, quiet evening like this, I always get a creepy feeling that they will all walk in through that window. And she continued, and she said to Mr. Nuttall, that, "Do you know what happens sometimes? I feel that they will definitely pass through this window, and they will just come back to this house through this window. Sometimes I also get fear." And after listening to that much, he got nervous, and this happens. Let us see the question answers. Comprehensive check, you must have And what is there in this particular comprehensive check? There are three questions. The first one is, why had Frampton Nuttall come to the rural retreat? Mr. Frampton Nuttall, he came to the rural retreat. Why? The answer to this question will be, Frampton Nuttall had been suffering from nervousness and worry. So he had come to the rural retreat for the cure of the same nervousness. This is what your first question is. Now, next question is, why had his sister given him letters of introduction to the people living there? His sister gave him a letters of introduction to people living there. Why? So the answer will be like this. His sister knew that he would meet very few people in the countryside. So he would feel very unhappy there. His condition would become worse than before. So she had given him the letters of introduction to the people she knew there, so that he could be safe for that purpose. So this is the answer to second question. Third question is, what had happened in this Appleton's family as narrated by the niece? What was the tragedy the young lady of 15 years narrated to Mr. Nuttall? So, a great tragedy had happened in this Appleton's family about 3 years ago. Her aunt, husband, brothers had gone actually for hunting as usually they used to go. And unfortunately, they were swallowed up by the mass. In that bog, they were swallowed. So that was the tragedy. They were returned. And this is how the chapter number 1 is over, children. We'll see the chapters part 2 in the next class. Thank you very much. That's all for the day.